non-fulfillment of the requirement. Okay, now what is the requirement? See, when we are saying non-fulfillment of the requirement is the non-conformity. What is the requirement? First of all, the requirement here becomes the once you start recording them, then you get data in front of you. action. Okay. So, where we are required to take an immediate action?
Something happened after that.
lean on all the samples after that and you can be okay with the sample.
All the samples you will learn in the lab.
You can have to go. CAP says you have to run all the samples again. They don't ask for this RE also, they do not agree with this RE. They say rerun all the samples. In this process, you may have to recall some reports also.
So, how many times the controller should not pass to rerun check the previous samples?
How many times the controller?
Like controls, in the first QMS sample is the control. And it has not passed. So, I will use another QC, which is quantity sufficient, and I will rerun it. And the control has passed.
Then that is not the way. Then it has passed.
So,
problem is if the control has been not passed.
Not passed for how many times?
At least twice if you have run it.
Morning samples, morning QC is okay, afternoon QC is fine.
Afternoon QC is fine. So, single time QC is fine. Do I need to rerun? If I have to rerun the QC, after how many times I have to rerun?
See, usually QC failed is QC failed. But sometimes what all of us do is we run the QC once again. And 80% of the time it passes.
So
you can maximum rerun once more. But it's not that keep on rerunning it. If twice the QC has failed, then it has failed. Root cause analysis, take some corrective action, whether we are changing the reagent, whether you are changing the QC material or whatever, or checking the fluctuation, checking the probe, or whatever. And whatever you assume that the QC passes, then only you can start running with the sample again. And as I am saying, you may have to recall certain sample reports also if the results have been released and you have had a QC failure later. Okay? So, you have a documented procedure to identify and manage the non-conformities in any aspect of the quality management system. As I said, pre-examination, examination and post-examination. You can maybe make different people responsible for different activities. Like maybe pre-examination or NCs will be seen by this person. Examination NCs will be seen by and recorded by this person. Post-examination by this. Or you can have one person. You can decide. As you... Okay? And but the procedure should ensure that responsibility and authorities for handling the non-conformities are all designated. Immediate action to be taken are defined and extent of the non-conformities determined. As I said, wherever it's going to directly affect your result, there you have to take an immediate action. Okay? So examinations are halted, reports withheld. Wherever the medical significance of the non-conformity is considered, where appropriate, the requesting physician or the authorized person is informed. Result of any non-conformity or potentially non-conformity audited is released a record. And responsibility for authorization or resumption of the examination is defined. Means once, suppose your QC failures happen, then if you are taken care of QCs, the QCs are passed, then who will authorize the release of the result or to authorize the restarting of the testing. Some authorized person has to give you the permission to start the retesting before the retesting starts. Okay, each episode of the non-conformity is documented, recorded, and these records are reviewed periodically. As we will go in the other clauses, we are reviewing this records in the management reviews also, we are doing this record in the internal audit also.
Each event is a non-conformity,
right? Each event which is, as I say, non-fulfillment of the requirement is a non-conformity. Okay. Here, the immediate action we are basically talking about, where it's directly, immediately affecting your result. But each event, which even if it's not affecting your result,
and it is 0.8%, but what we have given in the policy is 1%, and our TAT is say 0.8%. So is it a non-conformity?
If you define it 1, it's less than 1, it's okay.
and the
what if it is 1.2? Yes.
So every event is not a non-conformity but a policy.
Yes.
What we have said.
Whatever your requirement is, if it is not fulfilling that requirement, it becomes a non-conformity. Then requirement may be set by you, may be set by the standard, may be set by the NHK. Everything, wherever whoever is setting any requirement, you have to fulfill that requirement. Wherever you are not fulfilling that requirement, that becomes a non-conformity. See? Then the three important words.